Gimana gimana Mbak? Sehat? Apa kabar?
Sehat.
Akhir-akhir ini lagi kebetulan habis finish filming a TV series. Soalnya jadi lebih
Okay.
More casual.
Itu soal apa TV seriesnya?
It's actually 8 o'clock prime time. It's like a drama. Mm-hmm. Kind of talk about. Ada lupa bahasa Indonesia sekarang. Bicarain papa saya ada orang killed him, so I want to revenge.
So kayak kalau di Indonesia itu sinetron gitu.
Iya, sinetron.
Oke. Yang menarik ini Mbak Margaret ini kan cukup lama ya di sini, udah berapa tahun?
Wah, udah 10 tahun.
Nah, itu yang menarik Mbak, gimana ceritanya bisa ada di sini, baru berkarir di sini dan sukses gitu. Jadi ceritain gak Mbak awalnya gimana?
Papa saya orang Indonesia, jadinya saya tuh lahir di Indonesia, tapi mama saya orang Taiwan. Waktu itu sebenarnya saya lagi study in the States, and then I came back for vacation, cuma buat waktu itu Natal ya.
Di balik ke Indonesia?
Balik ke Taiwan. Okay. Dan gitu, soalnya waktu itu lagi I have a break a month or two months, and saya pengen belajar bicara bahasa Mandarin. Waktu itu Mandarin saya nggak gitu baik.
Jadi waktu itu hanya bahasa Indonesia dan Inggris.
Dan gitu balik ke Taiwan waktu itu susah banget, satu I can't even read one word, so I had to start over. But then I came back and then I was walking on the street. Well, some people asked me to go on casting for buat itu for iklan. commercial event.
Okay. Yeah. Itu tahun berapa tuh Mbak?
Waktu itu 2000 deh kayaknya.
2000 ya. Okay. Dari situ terus ya karir gitu, mulai ditawarin macam-macam gitu. Tapi sebenarnya orang tua sendiri, ibu sendiri juga artis ini kan?
Iya. Dulu mama saya she's a movie star from Hong Kong. So she did movies in Hong Kong.
Tapi waktu pas di Indonesia sendiri nggak kepikir untuk memulai karir di bidang entertainment.
Enggak. Soalnya dulu saya suka belajar udah gitu. Dulu saya sekolah di Pelita Harapan.
Di Tangerang ya.
Iya. Udah gitu di Sentul.
Oh,
terus mereka ada drama class. Udah gitu saya join ke drama classnya, and then I really like acting a lot. I mean, I like drama, I like being on stage, but nggak pernah pikir mau become an actress as a career.
Hanya karena suka gitu, atau mungkin terinspirasi suka sama mama juga.
Bukan mama. Waktu itu sebenarnya waktu saya sampai saya umur 8 tahun saya baru tahu mama tuh actress. So before that I never knew. So actually like dari kecil waktu itu saya masih ingat ya sama koko, kita duaan suka main gitu. Udah gitu our neighbors, all the kids, we would gather together and then we would play. Koko saya
jadi guru,
like write a story, and then we have to play parts. It's like a little drama. So since I was pretty young, I kind of know that I like being, you know, I like acting, but just as a hobby.
Jadi waktu itu hanya nggak kepikiran untuk serius berkarir ya, memang
nggak
acting seperti itu. Gitu.
I think it's sometimes. I think life is really weird. I think it brings you somewhere at the right moment. You just get there, and then I think it's meant to be.
Nah, di Indonesia sendiri itu loh, ketika tahun 2000 itu kan awal banyak bermunculan televisi swasta seperti itu kan, industri tanah air juga udah mulai bagus gitu. Kok saat itu nggak kepikiran untuk mulai karir dari Indonesia gitu, sebagai tanah kelahiran gitu kan, karena lahir di sana.
Waktu itu saya nggak pernah pikir mau ke mau acting. Terus my first work was from Taiwan. So I started in Taiwan not because like I wanted to be in Taiwan, but then Taiwan offered me the job. Jadi kalau mungkin kalau lain kali gitu ke Indonesia ada kerja, saya juga bisa balik ke Indonesia.
Ke negara lain ternyata ditawarnya di sana, ya mulai karirnya dari sana. Ya, seperti itu gitu ya.
Jadi saya nggak pernah pikir harus di Taiwan atau gimana, tapi I don't know, I think it just brings me here.
Nah, yang paling favorit banget kan waktu itu Snow Angel, kan?
Ah, yes, Snow Angel.
Iya, dengan Toro lah. Itu gimana tuh, maksudnya itu termasuk mulai karir banget ya, ketika mulai beranjak naik sekali ya, main bersama.
Tapi sebenarnya
gitu.
Waktu itu sebelum Snow Angel saya ada I was playing in a movie with Michelle Yeoh.
Yeah.
So I did that movie. I think that movie like brought me, like teach me a lot. And then with Toro, it was another like it's really different, but it's still my best two job was that. I think I really enjoyed working. And then Toro is a good friend, but and then he hasn't been acting for a little bit, right? So mean, I think Snow Angel is still like lebih banyak teman saya dari Indonesia watch Snow Angel.
Tantangannya gimana nih, Mbak? Kan Mbak orang asing gitu kan, masuk dan memulai karir dari sini dari nol banget gitu ya. Apa sih tantangannya ketika itu, Mbak?
Soalnya waktu itu saya ke Taiwan semuanya tuh like the habit, like the language, and then this is really different, so it's kind of hard for me to fit in at first. And then, soalnya dulu saya satu, even one character I can't read Chinese. So when I film, I have to have someone to record the whole thing, and then I have to memorize by nika, by a recorder, tape recorder.
Jadi harus ditemani terus ya.
Iya, waktu itu mama saya bacain semua scriptnya, begitu saya I have to like by listening, and then it's I think it's pretty hard. And then soalnya di Indonesia. Dari kecil sampai besar di Indonesia, jadinya sama Taiwan banyak saya nggak ngerti kalau mereka ngomong apa.
Like, jadi kendalanya lebih karena bahasa ya?
Iya, bahasa dan culture.
Persaingannya sendiri mah dengan artis-artis lokal seperti itu?
Well, I think the good thing about me is that I don't compare myself with other people, and I don't, and I try to do my best. So I think I'm pretty lucky. I don't feel that. I mean, of course, the competition is pretty high, but then as long as you do your best, I think there's always a stage for you out there.
Wow, okay, menarik nih, Mbak. Tapi ini pertanyaan masih cukup banyak. Mungkin kita sambil jalan nggak apa-apa ya, Mbak, ya, kenal ngobrol gitu ya.
Dipicu oleh kerusuhan Mei 1998. Karena tidak ingin anak mereka jadi korban, ayah Margaret mengungsikan bungsu dari dua bersaudara itu ke Pulau Formosa ini.
Yang waktu itu sempat baca-baca juga gitu kan di apa di internet, katanya Mbak waktu kesini karena pas kerusuhan Mei 98.
Ya, waktu itu benar-benar banyak gitu ya, and then everyone was worried. Nah gitu saya kebetulan mau SMA SMA 3 waktu itu di in Florida di Amerika. Nah gitu karena ada a pastor, a friend of ours, and then he introduced me, so I went to study in a Christian school.
Oh, jadi bukan karena waktu itu memang ada rame-rame kerusuhan itu Mbak diamankan gitu?
Enggak, waktu itu udah pas paling like when it was really bad, I was still in Indonesia. It was actually because I do wanted to go study abroad, and also of course my parents would be worried because I'm a girl, but mostly it's because it was about time for me to go. Soalnya koko saya udah di Amerika udah lama banget waktu itu. Waktu saya sekolah di Sentul, begitu banyak teman di Jakarta waktu itu, bener serem banget ya, soalnya semuanya all the roads was blocked and everything, but I was safe, but I think it was just mostly about time. Yes, I was scared, soalnya waktu itu ya buka TV ya semuanya juga pada takut, tapi waktu itu udah everything was fine before I left though.
Okay, keren, gara-gara ada tiba itu terus Mbak pergi dan Mbak nggak mau balik lagi ke
di Indonesia for retirement is really good. Right, I think it's like the whole
jadi sekarang cari uangnya dulu, nanti kalau di pensiun balik.
Sampai saat ini, pemilik nama Mandarin Huang Yuji ini telah membintangi sekitar 8 serial TV, 3 film layar lebar, dan beberapa iklan. Meski sekarang sudah punya nama di Taiwan, apa Margaret juga tertarik ya untuk merambah industri hiburan tanah air?
Pernah kepikiran buat nyoba terjun di dunia entertainment Indonesia nggak?
Sebenarnya waktu itu saya cici saya Cirani, dia juga she's a singer.
Oh iya, so, yang bawain tangan pesulap ya?
Iya.
Oh, itu kakaknya?
Iya.
Kakak kandung?
Bukan, it's kind of like what do you call it? Like not really related by blood, but we're just really really close.
Oh, okay.
So actually she did say that one time she came here and she's like, kamu mungkin kalau balik ke Indonesia bisa kerja di sana. And I thought about it, but never, soalnya di sana nggak ada, di Taiwan saya udah ada agent, jadinya agent saya nggak gitu kenal sama orang-orang di Indonesia. Iya, lebih susah.
Iya, karena kan sekarang di Indonesia itu lagi in tuh muka-muka yang Korea, yang Chinese itu lagi happening banget gitu kan. Pas masuk ke, mungkin ketika masuk ke pasarnya lebih mudah gitu, tapi belum pernah, belum mau coba ya kesana ya.
Saya mau, kalau misalnya kalau if there's a chance I would really go back, cause saya pengen banget di Indonesia kalau bisa kerja, kebetulan bisa ketemu papa kan, bisa ketemu sama teman-teman. I want to if I do get the chance.
Oke, tapi kan Mbak lahir di Indonesia gitu, besar di Indonesia dan di sini, ada perbedaan nggak sih antara di sini sama di Indonesia?
Wow, everything's kind of different. I'm glad I was born in Indonesia, cause like masih ingat gak apa dulu di Indonesia. Tiap kali kalau misalnya orang lain tuh lebih tua dari kamu 1 tahun atau 2 tahun, kita tuh panggil Mbak,
ya
kan, Mbak atau Koko atau apa. And then it's different in Taiwan or just it's really different here, cause we call people just by name, even though they're like 5 years older. Soalnya mereka tahu takut dipanggilnya terlalu tua.
Oh,
mereka lebih suka. Jadi pertama kali saya datang semuanya cici koko, semuanya cici koko, and they're like,
nah, mereka tersinggung. Oh, oke. Okay. Mereka tersinggung, dipikir tua enak aja bagi gue cici. Oh,
nah,
okay.
Gitu saya karena di Indonesia, I think I learned a lot of manners. I think orang Indonesia they're very sama papa, sama mama, sama orang tua tuh sangat how do you say, it's like I really like that.
And they care each other.
Yeah, I really love that about Indonesia. I mean, I really miss Indonesia actually.
Lalu apa yang paling dirindukan dari Indonesia? Makanannya kah atau sambelnya kah?
Sambel. Di sini ada satu itu restaurant, Indonesian restaurant. I always go there. Ayam kalasan ya, gado-gado. Saya makan I eat really like spicy food. So saya suka banget.
Di sini malah orang nggak terlalu suka pedes ya, nggak terlalu suka pedes, nggak terlalu suka garam.
Iya.
Terus ini
makanya saya suka di Indonesia udah gitu ikan gorengnya juga enak banget, sampai itu tulangnya bisa digigit.
Ada juga yang bilang karir Mbak ini dibayang-bayangi karir ibu gitu kan, ibu dulu punya nama besar ketika di Hong Kong. Merasa seperti itu juga nggak sih?
Not really. Actually, because my mom only acted for 2 years, so I never really had the pressure. A lot of people say my mom is really beautiful, and they always compare me with my mom, but I think I'm actually proud
beautiful.
Of her. My mom is really pretty. You should see her. She's really beautiful. So I'm actually happy, and I'm proud to have a mom like her. And she's, mama saya orangnya sangat, like, she's always happy, and she's always optimistic, which I think is really good, and I think I get that from her. So, like, yeah, I don't have much pressure. I think that's the good thing about me. It's like, banyak orang udah jadi aktor atau aktris, they get really stressed and they get really depressed. Like, because our work is like, when we're busy, we're really busy. But when we're not, like, you know, we just stay at home or, like, we do our own thing. Yeah, and I can do that. Like, I can easily do that. But a lot of people are not used to it. So they kind of, like, they get, like, because you're busy every day, you have all the schedule, all packed schedules, and then suddenly you're not doing anything. Some people get really depressed, which I think I don't have that, which I think is good.
Okay, okay. Nah, ini pertanyaan terakhir nih Mbak. Masih ada nggak yang ingin diraih gitu, cita-cita ke depan ingin seperti apa sih gitu? Bayangan sebelum retirement gitu.
Well, I always wanted to, like, I don't think I have filmed my best work yet. What I mean by best work is I want to do a movie or TV series that really reach out to people, which I don't think I have achieved that. Because actually my brother, he's a director. Well, he's not yet, but he learned filmmaking when he's in university. So my biggest dream is that I want to make a movie with him.
Oh.
And then it's going to be
mendapatkan Oscar.
No, not that far, but I think that's for now. I want to do my own project.
Okay.
Jadi gitu, saya benar pengen balik ke Indonesia.
Indonesia lagi booming banget loh Mbak.
I know. Ya, saya tahu. Makanya saya juga pengen balik ke Indonesia. Udah gitu kadang-kadang suka lihat ya. Jadinya, I think this is Chinese, but then she did a movie in Indonesia. I think it's really fun. I think I'm gonna look forward for that.
Okay.
Hopefully I'll see you in Indonesia.
Okay. Semoga ya Mbak.
Semoga.
Okay. Mbak, makasih banyak atas waktunya.
Ya,
semoga sukses, cita-citanya tercapai semua dan bisa pulang ke Indonesia ya.
Hopefully.
Oke, makasih banyak. Sampai ketemu lagi ya. Ketemu di Jakarta.
Iya,
Jakarta.
Ya, makasih.